Hello guys, what up? So welcome back to my channel. Before we get started for today, I have a question here. So, do you always try to stay cool with your coworkers and try to avoid any conflicts with them? If you do, after reading this article, you may change your mind about it. 好，我们看一下今天的这个标题啊，主题的话呢是关于这个anger， 是关于这个生气的啊。OK。Why you should lose your temper? 为什么呢？你应该发火啊，或者是那个发脾气。At work sometimes 啊，在工作的时候呢，有时候是吧？啊，为什么你在有时候呢？你在工作的时候呢，应该去发火啊，应该去那个 get angry. And without throwing anything 啊，但是呢，不应该去扔任何东西啊。OK 啊，要有一个度啊。OK， 我们听一下第一段。
Business.Bartleby, Anger and Management. The pros and cons of losing your temper at work.
Awareness days are meant to remind people of important causes and desirable behaviour. Among other things, February sees the International Day of Human Fraternity, World Day of Social Justice, and everyone's favourite, until it became a bit too commercialised, World Pulses Day.International Day of Happiness falls in March. You have to wait until November for World Kindness Day.
Okay, Awareness Days. Awareness Days 指的是那个意识日啊。那什么叫 Awareness Days? Awareness Days are special days, weeks or months, dedicated to raising awareness about important topics. 它是重要的一些那个，比如说某一天啊，或者是哪一周。啊，甚至是呢，有可能是那个啊，这那个按照某个月吧，那么它是致力于呢去啊去那个提升这个意识啊，关于重要的一些日子啊 ，OK， 好像在情人节之后的话呢，有一个是关爱单身狗的这么一个节日是吧 ？OK， 啊，单身的人的这么一个节日啊 ，OK， 好，翻译成呢留啊意识日或者是那个叫留意日啊。好，就翻译成意识日吧。好，那么这个所谓的意识日的话呢，是意味着 to remind people 啊，提醒人们啊，有重要提醒人们的重要的这个原因啊，还有这个desirable behavior 啊，应该鼓励的这个行为啊。desirable 的话呢是就是说想要的是吧？应该被鼓励的一些行为。Among other things, February sees the International Day of Human Fraternity, OK. 那么二月份的话呢，我们说这个 seize 就见证的意思啊，就是二月份的话呢是啊，是这个国际的一个叫人类关爱日吧 ，OK. 啊，人类互助日啊 ，fraternity 指的是那个关爱。当然，这个翻译的话呢，是我自己呢随便翻译的啊，可能它在国际上呢有专门的名称呢，我就不再去查了啊，大家感兴趣可以自己搜索一下。World Day of Social Justice 啊，叫世界正义日啊 ，justice 正义。And everyone's favorite until it became a bit too commercialized. World Pulses Day. Okay, 这个 pulse 呢指的是脉搏啊，心跳，但是它有这个斗笠的这个意思啊。那么这个世界的斗笠的节日啊啊，世界斗笠日啊，叫 World Pulses Day. Okay, 啊，大家都喜欢的一个节日呢，直到它呢变得有一点那个太商业化了，叫世界斗笠日。This is the first time I ever heard about it. 这是我第一次听说啊，有这个节日是吧？那么吃什么呢？吃这个臭豆腐嘛，是吧 ？OK， 好。International Day of Happiness falls in March. 这个叫幸福日吧，国际幸福日啊，快乐日。那么是在三月份。OK， you have to wait until November for World Kindness Day. 那么世界呢善良日啊。你需要等到那个十一月份 ，OK？ 好，这些节日的话呢，都不太了解啊。我们听下一段，下一部分。
Anger is far too objectionable to be celebrated with a special day of its own. There is an Anger Awareness Week in Britain, but the emphasis is on controlling tempers, not giving in to them. Yet in the workplace, as elsewhere, anger is more ambiguous than it seems.
Okay, anger is far too objectionable to be celebrated with a special day of its own. 那么这个 objectionable 指的是那个引起反对的是吧？那么 这个叫生气的话呢，是反对的就是太多了嘛，他就不可能成为一个被庆祝是吧？成为一个什么特殊的一个他自己的一个什么节日啊？A special day of its own. There is an anger awareness week in Britain. 在这个英国的话呢，有一个 anger awareness 要叫做生气呢觉察的日子啊，就是对生气呢你要有意识的日子。那么这个一听呢就知道呢，你是要关注这个生气这回事儿啊，不是让你鼓励你去生气是吧？但是他后边就解释了 ，But the emphasis 这个强调啊 ，is on controlling temperament 是关于这个控制你的这个叫脾气啊，控制你的脾气 ，not giving in to them。give in 的话呢是一个动词，表示那个叫屈服，不要向这个生气呢去屈服啊，向你的这个负面情绪呢，就是易怒啊，或者是那个发怒的这个东西呢，去屈服它。Yet in the workplace， 但是呢，在这个工作场景里边，as elsewhere 啊，就像其他地方一样 ，anger is more ambiguous than it seems。就是生气的话呢，比它看起来的话呢，要更加的这个模糊啊。这个地方他说生气的话呢，要更加模糊，可能里边的话呢，有一些是。故意装作生气的一些东西呢，还是说就是你不能分辨呢什么是真正的这个生气，还是说呢它并不好定义是吧？那么这个地方的话呢，它本身呢也是有点模糊的是吧 ？OK， 好，我们看下一段啊，我们听下一段。
Its destructive side is obvious. Furious people are not much fun to work with, and less fun to work for.A short-fused boss is likely to instill fear among employees and to discourage people from speaking up. Anger can also engender poor performance. Anyone who has ever been riled by a rude email or uncivil colleague knows how in such circumstances, suddenly nothing else matters. Every spare bit of cognitive power is redirected to thinking of devastating put-downs from which the offender will never recover.Other tasks can wait.
Its destructive side is obvious. Okay， 它的这个破坏性的这方面的话呢是非常明显的。它就是那个发怒啊，生气的这个破坏性的方面呢是非常明显的。Furious people are not much fun to work with. 易怒的人啊 ，furious 就是发火的是吧？易怒的人的话呢，那个和他们一起工作呢一点都没有意思啊。Okay。And less fun to work for. 那么你给他们工作，给他们打工的话呢，更加没意思了。Okay. A short-fused boss is likely to instill fear among employees and to discourage people from speaking up. Okay. 我们知道这个 fuse 这个词的话呢，有这个引线的意思啊，导火索的意思。那么，如果一个人的导火索呢，非常的短，是吧？你点一点就着嘛，非常的形象，是吧？就是易怒的。A short-fused boss， 一个易怒的老板的话呢。有可能啊，会那个灌输啊 ，to instill fear， 灌输这个叫恐惧呢，在他的这个员工里边 ，among employees and to discourage people， 那么去不鼓励人们啊，或者让人们气馁呢，就是去那个说自己的意见啊。OK，anger can also engender poor performance。那么我们说发怒的话呢，生气呢，也会那个engender 引发呢不好的这个工作成绩。Anyone who has ever been riled by a rude email or uncivil colleagues knows how in such circumstances suddenly nothing else matters. Okay. Anyone 啊，这个地方呢应该做主语了是吧？后边呢应该一个定语修饰它，什么样的人呢？一个人，任何一个人啊，那么曾经呢被riled 啊 ，riled 指的是那个被激怒了是吧？被什么激怒了？被一封那个不礼貌的email。或者是一个不太这个礼貌的啊 ，civil 就是不礼貌的，是吧？不礼貌的同事呢，所打扰了之后呢，这个人知道，这个人知道是吧 ？How in such circumstances 啊？那怎么在这样的一个环境里边呢？马上啊，立刻，其他的东西啊 ，nothing else 啊 ，matter 都不重要了啊，就是什么东西呢？其他别的什么东西都不重要了啊 ，OK。Every spare bit of cognitive power is redirected to thinking of the devastating putdowns, from which the offender will never recover. Okay, 那么这个所有的 every 那个 spare 呢是空缺的啊，空缺的 a bit of cognitive power 就是很就是所有的每一点的这种认知的这个力量啊，就是空余的认知的力量，就是说白了就是剩余的这个脑力吧，所有的脑力呢 都是被重新定位了，定位到那个思考什么呢？是一些那个破坏性的一些这个打击吧。什么样的打击的话呢？就是后面呢是修饰这个打击啊，修饰这个打击。From which the offender will never recover. OK，那么这个 from 的话呢，可以放在最后边是吧？Which the offender will never recover from. OK，就是这个攻击者呢，从来就是他们使他们永不会恢复的这么一种打击力，看到了吗？那么就是说这个被激怒的这个人的话呢，他所有脑力呢，所有的这个精力都在考虑呢，怎么去报复啊，怎么去思考一个那个有破坏力的打击啊，让这个攻击别人的人呢，再也恢复不了的这么一种东西。所以说呢，在占脑力嘛，影响工作嘛，是吧？Other tasks can wait，别的工作都可以等一等啊，都可以等一下。OK，遇到那个没有礼貌的这个同事呢，也确实够大家喝一壶的，是吧？OK，好，我们听下一段。
In one paper on the effects of rudeness on medical professionals, Arya Riskin of B'nai Zion Medical Center in Haifa and his co-authors describe a training exercise in which teams of Israeli physicians and nurses treated a mannequin of a baby. The teams were joined by someone billed as a visiting expert from America, who offered studiously neutral comments to some groups and made unprompted and disparaging remarks about the quality of medical care in Israel to others. The teams that had suffered rudeness performed significantly worse.
OK，in one paper on the effects of rudeness on medical professionals. OK，这个地方呢引用了论文了是吧？一篇论文的话呢是关于这个影响啊，就是那个粗鲁的影响，对别人粗鲁的影响是吧？对谁粗鲁呢？是对这个叫medical professionals 医疗方面的专业人员啊。OK，AR 这个人 B'nai Zion Medical Center 啊，是一个叫 BZ。叫医疗中心的这么一个人啊，OK，是在这个 Haifa 应该是以色列的是吧？OK，AR 这个人 and his co-authors 他的这个叫联合作者的话呢，describe a training exercise 描述了一个叫做training 就是一个培训的一个练习啊，in which teams of Israeli physicians OK，那什么样的练习的话呢？是这个以色列的医生的团队啊，还有一些护士啊，treated a mannequin of a baby。他们在治疗的话呢，是一个小 baby 的一个叫做人体模型。The teams were joined by someone billed as a visiting expert from America. OK，那么这个团队的话呢，就是有人加入了啊，是谁呢？是一个人呢，自我介绍呢，是一个访问的专家啊，来自于美国，who offered studiously neutral comments。他提供了一些刻意的一些这种叫中立的一些评价呢，对这个团队是吧？然后呢，made unprompted and disparaging remarks about the quality of medical care in Israel to others，做出了一些呢 unprompted prompt 我们知道是提示呢，就是没有经过提示的啊，OK，就是自发的一些这个自发的，还有一些这个贬低的 disparaging 是贬低的 disparaging，评论 remarks about the quality of medical care in Israel，关于呢是这个医疗的这个质量，在以色列的质量是吧？就是他做的这些评论呢，是给别人评论，就给那些人评论的嘛。To others, the team had suffered rudeness, performed significantly worse。那么这个团队啊，就是遭受了这些批评的，就是这个无理对待的这个团队的话呢，他的工作的话呢，就是差了很多。所以说呢，这是一个影响嘛，是吧？就是别人呢对，如果是别人对你进行攻击的话呢，或者是呢，有些人的话呢，我们知道这个叫。有一个词呢叫 troll 是吧？这个有时候也是比较常见的嘛。但是呢，就是你，其实对我来说的话呢，当然有时候也会生气嘛。但是呢，你要知道，别人的观点呢，只是他的想法呢，他有自由发表他的观点嘛，对吧？但是呢，有时候事实呢就是事实嘛，这是不一样的啊。所以说呢，他说自己的观点呢，就是我可以反驳嘛，我可以举过自己的证据嘛，是吧？尽量的不去生气，但是如果有人那故意那个人身攻击的话呢，那拉黑就好了，对吧？OK，好，这是这个这一部分，我们听下一段啊，OK。
Being angry all the time is bad news for individuals and organizations alike. but so is being tremendously satisfied by everything all the time. Jeffrey Pfeiffer, a professor at Stanford University who teaches a course on how to acquire power, reckons that displaying anger is an important skill for those who want to rise up the corporate ladder. It is associated with decisiveness and competence. Though angry women are more likely to evoke negative emotions among other people than angry men do. Doctors who get angry if they are challenged about their medical advice are not judged to be less competent. If they show shame, patients take a dimmer view.
Okay, being angry all the time is bad news for individuals and organizations alike. Okay.那么一直很生气的话呢，是一个非常糟糕的一个消息啊，对于这个个体还有这个叫机构都是一样的。 OK， 在那个我的 Skype 好友里边呢，有一个人呢就是一直是很愤怒的啊。 OK， 那么最后的话呢，他被所有人都拉黑了。 OK， 不知道为什么会有这样的性格是吧。 OK， but so is being tremendously satisfied by everything all the time。 OK，好，这个地方是一个倒装啊。OK， 我们知道一直生气不好，但是一直是 being tremendously satisfied， 一直很开心的话呢，对所有的事情都很开心呢。Is so 也是一样的，也是不好的。OK， 好，为什么呢？我们要听后边的解释吧。后边内容我没有全读完呢，但是我猜一下，因为那个anger 呢，或者是 you know when you lose your temper 啊，当你那个发脾气的时候，它其实也是一种正常的情绪吧，对吧？那么有时候人们也是需要 release their anger 啊，需要那个发泄一下，对吧？或者是呢会有一个怎么说呢释放的这个渠道吧。所以说呢一直不生气的话呢可能也不太好啊，这当然是我自己的猜测啊。我们看一下Jeffrey Pfeiffer 啊，不知道为什么这么发音啊。 OK， professor at Stanford University， 他是那个Stanford University 斯坦福大学的一个教授， who teaches a course on how to acquire power，他教的一门课的话呢是怎么获得这个权利啊。 Reckons that 啊，就是那个发现呢 displaying anger is an important skill for those who want to rise up the corporate ladder。 OK， 展示你的这个愤怒的话呢是一个重要的技能啊，让谁呢，让那些人呢想去爬升的，在公司里边爬升那些人。 OK， rise up the corporate ladder。 OK， 如果是展示这个 anger 的话呢，当然也是一种控制别人的手段嘛，是吧。使用这个情绪去控制别人啊。 OK， It is associated with decisiveness， 它和呢什么有关联啊？ Associated with 和这个决断性有关联，还有这个叫竞争力。 Though angry women are more likely to evoke negative emotions， 但是呢愤怒的女性的话呢更容易去激发一些这个负面的情绪在其他人之间啊。Than angry men do， 比那个愤怒的男性呢就是更容易激发这个负面的情绪，当然这是他的结论，和我没有关系啊。OK， doctors who get angry if they are challenged about their medical advice are not judged to be less competent。 OK， 那么医生的话呢，生气的这个医生啊，如果他们是被挑战了关于什么呢，关于他们的这个就是医疗的建议呢，那么这些医生的话呢并没有被判断为没有竞争力啊。就是医生呢对于别人挑战他的建议这方面呢，就是会不会被认为呢这个医生不行啊。If they show shame， 如果他们对这种批评意见展示的是这个羞耻感patients take a dimmer view 啊 ，take a dimmer view 啊，那么这个病人的话就会更加悲观啊，这个也好理解吧。大家希望呢医生呢是有这个决断力的嘛，是自信的啊。如果医生呢被批评呢，他就变得非常的害羞啊，那么这个也不好，对吧？医生这个病人的话呢，不知道就该怎么看了啊，会更加的这个悲观啊。Dimmer 我们知道是更加灰暗的啊，昏暗的。好了，我们把整个的听力呢，我们再听一遍。
Business Bartleby Anger and Management.The pros and cons of losing your temper at work.
Awareness days are meant to remind people of important causes and desirable behaviour. Among other things, February sees the International Day of Human Fraternity, World Day of Social Justice, and everyone's favourite, until it became a bit too commercialised, World Pulses Day. International Day of Happiness falls in March. You have to wait until November for World Kindness Day. Anger is far too objectionable to be celebrated with a special day of its own. There is an Anger Awareness Week in Britain, but the emphasis is on controlling tempers, not giving in to them. Yet in the workplace, as elsewhere, anger is more ambiguous than it seems. Its destructive side is obvious. Furious people are not much fun to work with, and less fun to work for. A short-fused boss is likely to instill fear among employees and to discourage people from speaking up. Anger can also engender poor performance. Anyone who has ever been riled by a rude email or uncivil colleague knows how in such circumstances suddenly nothing else matters. Every spare bit of cognitive power is redirected to thinking of devastating put-downs from which the offender will never recover. Other tasks can wait. In one paper on the effects of rudeness on medical professionals, Arya Riskin of B'nai Zion Medical Center in Haifa and his co-authors describe a training exercise in which teams of Israeli physicians and nurses treated a mannequin of a baby. The teams were joined by someone billed as a visiting expert from America, who offered studiously neutral comments to some groups and made unprompted and disparaging remarks about the quality of medical care in Israel to others. The teams that had suffered rudeness performed significantly worse. Being angry all the time is bad news for individuals and organisations alike. But so is being tremendously satisfied by everything all the time. Jeffrey Pfeiffer, a professor at Stanford University who teaches a course on how to acquire power, reckons that displaying anger is an important skill for those who want to rise up the corporate ladder. It is associated with decisiveness and competence. Though angry women are more likely to evoke negative emotions among other people than angry men do. Doctors who get angry if they are challenged about their medical advice are not judged to be less competent. If they show shame, patients take a dimmer view.